Hello dear students, welcome to the channel Visual Physics Tutor. So today you will be learning electric field at a point on the axis of a dipole or electric field at a point on axial line of an electric dipole, or this can be also called electric field at the end position of a dipole. So for this we have to consider a dipole of length 2a and center O. So let us consider a dipole of length 2a. So let us first construct a dipole. So suppose now this is a minus q charge at point A, and here I have plus q charge at point B. So now this system constitutes a dipole. So now this is, now along the axis I can say that the length between the minus q charge and plus q charge is 2a, and let its center be O. Now from the center O throughout the axis at a point P, let this point P be at a distance R. Now we have to calculate the electric field at the point P, which is along the axis of the electric dipole. Now for this, now we know that this section will be again A here, and this section will be also A over here. Now let us consider that a test charge is kept at point P. So let us take a small test charge, a Q naught is placed at point P, and this is a positive test charge. So now we know that the test charges are vanishingly small. It will not have an effect directly on the source charge, but source charge can exert its force on the test charge. So now let us calculate the electric field at P due to the charge minus Q at A. So I will write here, electric field at P due to charge minus Q at A. So we know the formula is E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. This is the general formula for the electric field. So here it is, electric field at A is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R plus A the whole square. Now you can see it is R plus A the whole square. That means the total distance from the center to the point P is R. Now from the center O to the point A where the charge minus Q is located, it is A. So it is R plus A. So it is R plus A the whole square. Now you can see the direction. The direction of this electric field is towards the left. So why it is towards the left? Because we know that at point P we have placed a test positive charge Q naught. Now this Q naught, which is placed at point P, will be attracted towards point A because minus Q charge, that is the source charge, is sufficiently stronger. So I can write here towards left. Now similarly, we have to find the electric field at P due to the charge plus Q at B. So I can write here now, electric field at P due to charge plus Q at B. Now this is given by EB is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R minus A the whole square. Now you can check for the direction. Now it is the positive charge, source charge placed at B. Now you have at point P again a test charge that is also positive. Now this plus Q charge located at B will repel the test charge placed at point P. So that will be repelled towards right. So I can write here the direction is towards right. So you can see that for the electric field, the direction is towards left and for at A, and for electric field at B, the direction is towards right. Now we have to find which electric field is greater, whether EB is greater or EA is greater. Now we know that here EB is greater than EA. Why is it so? Because we know that from the formula E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square, R and E are inversely proportional. So we can say that lesser the R, greater will be the electric field, correct? So in that case now R minus A is less or R plus A is less. So we can see that here R minus A is less. So I can write here, since R minus A is less than R plus A, that means the electric field at B will be greater than electric field at A. So I can write here now, net electric field at P, this can be E is equal to EB minus EA. So now let us substitute the values of EB and EA. So it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q can be taken common here. So 1 by R minus A the whole square minus 1 by R plus A the whole square. Now we can solve here. So I can get here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, taking the LCM and solving, here I can get here R plus A square minus R minus A the whole square by R plus A the whole square into R minus A the whole square. Now on solving this I can get here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, a Q is there, Q 4 AR pi R square minus A square the whole square. Now this 4 AR can be split into 2 A into 2 R. So I can write here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into 2A into 2R divided by R square minus A square the whole square. Now you know that what P is equal to Q into 2A. P is equal to Q into 2a. Now we can see whether in this formula we have the terms q and 2a. Of course, we have q here, we have 2a here. So I can write here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So instead of 2a and q, I can write here p. Now again, what remains is r. So instead of 2a and q, I can write p, and again 2 is remaining, so that 2 is written here and it is r. So it is 2pr by r square minus a square the whole square. Now you can see that if the dipole length is very very small, we can neglect a square. So I can write here if dipole length is very small, we can neglect a square. So once we neglect this, the equation can be written as E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught to p by this r square, it's the whole square, so it becomes r to the power 4. R to the power 4 and the r in the numerator get cancelled and you get r cube. So I can write here r cube. So we get a formula E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2p by r cube. Now we can put this in the vector form. So I can write here, therefore E vector is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2p by r cube r cap. Now on the axial line of an electric dipole, p vector and e vector are parallel to each other and the angle between them theta is 0. Now on the axial line of an electric dipole, P vector and E vector are parallel to each other and angle between them theta is 0 degree. So hope you have understood this derivation, and thanks.